the leadership of the Forum for Democratic Change, FDC, Katunga faction stormed the Electoral Commission's EC offices today, demanding registration forms to begin the process of registering their new party. This follows the EC's delay in responding to the faction's letter, dated September 16, 2024, in which they requested the registration of their new party, the People's Front for Freedom. Lord Mayor Erias Lukwago, the interim leader of the FDC Katunga faction, accused the Electoral Commission for playing hide-and-seek to frustrate and sabotage the yet-to-be-registered party, the People's Front for Freedom, PFF.
Okuvanga kumi na mukaga, olwalira abiri mu ssatu, commission tetuulanga, kati ne bweba tetuulanga, at least tetuli biwuduwudu, tetuli logs, tubuulire nti olunaku bweruti ne bweruti commission egenda kutuula era ensonga zammwe tujja kuziddamu.
The Electoral Commission spokesperson Paul Bukenya informed the Lukwago and team that commissioners were unavailable to meet them but promised to respond to their letter in due course. Lukwago, alongside Harold Kaija and Doreen Nyanjura, the Kampala Deputy Lord Mayor, had gone to meet the EC chairperson to discuss issues concerning the delayed registration of the new political party.
Yeah, banaffe bano batuwandikira ebbaluwa nga balina ensonga ze batutegeezaako era ebbaluwa twagifuna. Esooka twagifuna ne tubalungamya, bye twabalungamya, ensonga ze twabalungamya ne babaako ate obuwandiika obulala bwe baakola. Twabufuna. Era tubulina era butunuulirwa akakiiko tujja kuba nga tubaddamu nga tubalungamya okusinziira ku mateeka nga bwe gatambula.
The Uganda Wildlife Authority Rangers took part in the World Wildlife Ranger Challenge at the historic Musician Falls National Park. The event witnessed rangers carrying a challenging 22 kg weight for men and 10 kilograms weight for women on their backs while on a grueling 21-kilometer run. The event was officially flagged off by the German ambassador to Uganda, Matthias Square, who also participated in the 21-kilometer challenge.
So, on your marks. Get set, go!
The goal was to elevate the status of wildlife rangers by highlighting their diverse responsibilities and the daily challenges they face. By raising funds for their essential conservation work, the challenge aims to support their efforts in protecting global wildlife. Teams from renowned national parks Queen Elizabeth, Kibale, Ziwa, Kidepo, Murogole Conservancy, and the host Musician Falls participated in this remarkable challenge.
In Kidepo, like we've been engaging so much of patrols, mobiles, and since it is the furthest large park, we have been moving for quite some distance. Eh? Yeah, so our body, I think that body, you mean we had already gotten used to some at least long distances and so forth. So.
To my teammates, guys, thank you for believing in me that we could make it to the finishing line, okay?
The event attracted a diverse array of participants ranging from wildlife enthusiasts, conservation advocates to artists.
It's been such a delight to always come here to the game reserves, to the wildlife and work with the wildlife rangers, because without the rangers we tend to lose a lot of our animals, and if we don't have this, if we don't protect what we have, then we lose our heritage as well.
It reminds us, you know, during training you go through endurance, you go through perseverance, all this stuff. Now, this one ranger day also reminds us of these values. Being professional in what you do, teamwork, endurance.
During a ceremony in New York, Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky received the prestigious Golden Plate Award from the American Academy of Achievement. The distinction has recognized global leaders in politics, science, arts, literature, and business for over 60 years. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky on Sunday arrived in the United States for a crucial visit to present Kyiv's plan to end 2.5 years of war with Russia. Zelensky will present his proposals, which he calls a victory plan, to President Joe Biden as well as presidential hopefuls Kamala Harris and Donald Trump.
We are short of time to define what the outcome will be. And we must define it, not Russia, not their bloody allies, We need to be faster. We need not to lose the next few months in war so that we don't lose next decades.
The visit comes after a summer of intense fighting, with Moscow advancing fast in eastern Ukraine and Kyiv holding on to swaths of Russia's Kursk region. The visit comes after a summer of intense fighting, with Moscow advancing fast in eastern Ukraine and Kyiv holding on to swaths of Russia's Kursk region.